as long-distance trains in the UK have become more modern and sleeker on the outside, unfortunately they seem to have become much more uncomfortable on the inside with particularly rock-hard seats. However, today we're going to be travelling from here in London at King's Cross all the way up to Edinburgh with a relatively new train company, which I believe is bucking the trend. Perhaps their seats will be more comfortable. Let's go and find out. Welcome to an absolutely gorgeous day here in London at King's Cross Station. I'm actually quite excited. I'm travelling for the first time with a train company called LUMO. They've been around for about the last 12 months and they're an alternative now to LNER, the London North East Railway, which has had the monopoly on the East Coast Mainline for so long. Now, I've done reviews of LNER both in standard class and first class on the channel before, and I've been particularly scathing of the seats in standard class on LNER. Let's face it, they are like sitting on concrete ironing boards. They're so upright and so completely uncomfortable that I get backache within about 25 minutes. So what's been happening over the last 5 to 6 years is a complete replacement of the entire long-distance train fleet within the UK. Most of the old trains have been replaced by variations of the Class 800 series from Hitachi. LNER, GWR and TransPennine Express all have the same really uncomfortable ironing board seats, but LUMO are the first company to try a different form of seat, and I've heard really good reports about the LUMO seats, even though they're all standard class. So I'm really looking forward to seeing today whether finally we'll get a comfortable ride in standard class from here in London up to Edinburgh. Let's go and find out. I do love the mixture of old style architecture and brand new modern archways here at King's Cross. It looks fantastic. Well, as you can see, the station is absolutely rammed with people. I've just found out that the LUMO service is delayed. But it doesn't say for how long, it just says delayed. Is it 10 minutes? Is it 30 minutes? Is it an hour? Who knows? Wouldn't it be ironic if they cancelled it and they transferred us all back onto an LNER service? Delayed for about 15 minutes, and as soon as they announced the platform, there was a mad flood of people trying to get to the train. Let's have a look round the inside. The seats are configured in a 2x2 configuration, mainly airline style, but there are a few tables with seats grouped round them. And here comes the acid test. Will these seats be more comfortable than LNER? Well, this is a good start. Padded ears for you to rest your head against. Lots of padding in the lumbar region. And at the base, the important base, yes, very springy indeed. I'm not complaining about this legroom at all. There's absolutely bags of it. Look at this, plenty of space to stretch right out. And on the seat in front of us,
a very sturdy table for refreshments or laptops. And once you've pulled it down, you can actually extend the table for bigger laptops. And I love this next feature. It's quite innovative. A reading light built into the back of the seat with two levels of brightness. Very clever. And right down under the seat, power for laptops and phones. A 3-pin plug and two USBs.
Well, I'm pleasantly surprised. Now, I'll preface that by saying that my expectations were as rock bottom as LNER seats are rock hard. But the LUMO seats are a massive improvement. They are genuinely actually quite comfortable. There's a lot of padding on the base, and there's a lot of padding in the lumbar support region to give you a good ride on your back, whilst the LNER seats are absolutely bolt upright, which is also very uncomfortable. These LUMO seats have an element of recline built into them. Now, you can't recline it any more, but that extra element of recline adds to the comfort value. I'm pretty impressed with this, do you know? I've never really been one for doing reviews of toilets on trains, but as it's my first time on a LUMO, I thought I'd come in and have a look. What can I say? It's just like any toilet on any train. Well, we made it. Welcome to Edinburgh Waverley. 4.5 hours on a LUMO train and not one twinge of backache. This could be a game changer for me. Do you know, I fancy a pint of beer. Let's go and grab a pint and I'll tell you a little bit more how I feel. Oh, I was really ready for that ice-cold pint of beer. Well, do you know what? From now on, if I have to travel from Edinburgh to London, or London to Edinburgh, on the train, apart from treating myself to first class on LNER from time to time, it's going to be LUMO for me. Those seats, compared to LNER's concrete ironing boards, were an absolute revelation. Not one twinge of backache in 4.5 hours. Actually, really quite comfy. Now, when LUMO launched, they set themselves up as a low-cost alternative, and they were charging fares of about £15 to about £25. I paid £65 today, which is a little bit along the same lines as LNER, so maybe they haven't fulfilled that low-cost promise, but for those seats, it's an absolute no-brainer. for me going forward. Have you travelled with LUMO? I'd love to know what you think of their service and the seats on their Class 803 trains. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel. And until the next video, remember, there's always something to see and to drink, so get out there and find it.